On July 6, 2018, Elon Musk, at this point, equipped with insufficient information of the cave system, suggested on Twitter to insert a nylon tube through the cave and inflate it like a bouncy castle in order to rescue the 12 trapped boys and their football coach.
So is that a joint?
John Volanton, one of the British rescue divers, called Elon's bouncy castle suggestion the Great Sausage Plan. Because even if there was a way laying 1.5 kilometer of strong and heavy plastic tubing through the cave, the tube would have surely collapsed and therefore trapped everybody in much the same way a skin binds the sausage meat in a pork banger. But on the same day, on the morning of Friday, Andrew Branagh, the CEO of the Arcata-based Wing Inflatables, received a call from Elon Musk and the SpaceX engineering team to construct an inflatable escape pod for the rescue of the children. And just a few hours later, by 9:30 a.m., a prototype was ready. The result was a submersible torpedo, which could hold a person with an air tank and a breathing apparatus. The rescue pod was 2 meters long, sealed with Velcro, and inflatable with the passengers' exhaled air. Meanwhile, Elon tweeted about the progress of the inflatables, trying to get in contact with the cave divers at the rescue site for some feedback. And by 1 p.m., the rescue pods were tested in the Arcata community pool with Charlie Nothoff, a certified dive instructor who supervised the testing, and two individuals who didn't know how to swim.
If you go underwater, make sure you just keep the regulator in your mouth. It'll breathe dry fine, but if you take it out of your mouth, you're going to be getting some water. So okay. There's a way to deal with that, but we haven't gotten there yet. So keep it in your mouth.
Okay.
And I can hear you say okay.
If he starts freaking out, I told him to just punch right through this.
Yeah.
The signal.
Just don't spit that thing out.
Yeah, just don't spit the thing out.
The Wing Inflatable CEO, Andrew Branagh, stated that the pods represented a last resort of unproven efficiency. But with oxygen levels in the cave dropping and monsoons on the way in, it's one more option for the rescue on the scene. Andrew Branagh said, "This is not the ideal system. We are hoping the pumps will work and they can get out another way. With more engineering and testing, the pods could evolve into a wonderful solution and a new product for use in cave rescues, which occur year-round all over the world." Little fun fact, while the Wing Inflatables crew called the rescue pods torpedoes, the SpaceX team named them body bubbles. But Elon just simply called them inflatable pods. Just a few hours after pool testing, at 5:15 p.m., Elon's private jet arrived at the Arcata airport, where the Wing team loaded 5 of the pods on board for transport to Thailand. Then the team stayed until 1 in the morning and built more units. Enough units to get all 12 boys plus their coach out of the cave and into the daylight. 8 more flew out next day, Saturday morning at 8 a.m. And while the inflatables were in the air on the way to Thailand, Elon Musk was hedging his bets with another design approach. An escape pod, a rescue capsule, a kit-sized miniature submarine, in which he could extract the children safely out of the cave. But first, Elon had to get in touch with the leader of the dive operation, Rick Stanton. Next, did Elon just randomly build a mini submarine? Or was he working with the dive team on the new design?